was part of the youth in the circle of a rampant HIV/AIDS prevalence, and there's a lot of infection. So we started a youth group, educating youth, bringing youth together to understand they're the future leaders and they have to take care of themselves. I've done that one since 1998, way back into 2000. We started outreaching to donors and to friends and to partners. We happened to bump on Pamoja Trust. Lawrence Apio took his initiative to come and visit our groups. And we had a time with him, and we had a lot of deliberations. Like, today you are very busy educating people about getting protection against HIV/AIDS. What about your economic life? What will you do? And then we say, okay, we depend on parents, we depend on some support NGOs, your partners in the region. We depend on training, we depend on incentives and what to do with activities for the NGOs, when you go do dramas for the CDC. I realize there's need for you to begin doing savings. You need to save for your future. You're still youths, still young, still vibrant, energetic. Can you start doing daily savings? As for me, like always in the evening, I will help my mom with the small business we used to do in the market, and ask my mom, can you give me just 10 shillings to save? And she'll say definitely yes. So I can remember at some point I had difficulties in paying my Form 1 school fee and had to borrow some money from that savings. So from then we started mobilizing many mamas, many men, many babas to join our saving groups. Our saving groups grown from 18 member group to 250 people towards the year 2001. Apio will come and visit us sometimes and see how we are saving, give us the books and tell us, this is great. Whenever he comes, he finds us, we have improved, and he says, this is great. Then in 2001, then he came and challenged us. How do you feel that when you're doing this thing for yourself? Don't you think other people also need this kind of a system? In Kisumu, there's this poor culture of savings. Can you mobilize other people? So through these mamas, we started outreaching to many groups in Nyalenda. So we started what's called Nyalenda Local Network. And this local network could come and visit and support us with like inspirational talk. From then, my group alone had already raised 350,000. It was not revolving. We had kept this money in a bank account. They took loans, some took 10,000 shillings, some took 5,000 shillings. They started improving their business. And Federation started growing from that point. So our growth again was propelled in 2002, 2003, when we had our first exchange to Kambimoto to see the housing. The reality now of you're seeing the family of the Federation, the old Wazee, the young youths, and you could even participate in doing daily collection in those exchanges. And it was fun. In fact, I remember in our group, most of the youths were now grabbing the responsibility of being collectors, daily collectors. Every day we have different daily collectors. After you've collected, you go surrender that money to the treasurer. The treasurer takes the money to the bank account. Used to save at Pandipiri Catholic Center Community Bank. That bank was just some kind of a card. You save, they write it in, someone write it in his own handwritings and signs it, and we just had to trust the old process of banking, because we were not able to access the commercial banking and get the electronic verification of banking and so forth. To me, it was a call. It was so inspiring to engage the Federation. I remember even at late 2000, I had to drop out of school because I couldn't manage school fee. I said, I'm engaging all my life into Federation. I want to see this thing go, because my mom business can't afford my high school fee. My dad incomes can't afford my high school fee. So that's where I started engaging fully in the Federation. That's from that point, I've never ever missed a point or a day or a single moment into the Federation activity.